SpaceX now laughing about impeachment on the very same day that Nancy Pelosi officially went on the record unleashing a hyper-constitutional attack on the 45th president. She's so somber about it, so concerned about the historical damage that she's inflicting on this republic, that she goes on late night television to joke about it with a so-called comedian. Joining me now, the founder of the American Truth Project and Daily Ledger contributor, Barry Nussbaum. Barry, Nancy Pelosi and company, they're very crafty, because what was voted on and what was passed in the House of Representatives on Thursday was not an impeachment resolution. It was just kind of a vanilla, typical House of Representatives resolution that set up the, quote, rules, the very biased rules for the impeachment inquiry. If they had passed an impeachment resolution, then precedence tells us it would have triggered due process for the Republicans, the Republican caucus, and for the White House. And of course, they don't want that. They don't want a level playing field.
The comments that Nancy Pelosi made last night on, as you said, a comedian show were very telling. When she said no person is above the law, she got a big standing ovation. But what she should have continued was, and no one is below the law, meaning you can't have a kangaroo court in Congress where the person being accused is not allowed to name witnesses, cross-examine witnesses, present evidence, all the due process guarantees under our Constitution. Graham, I hate to call it a kangaroo court because it's insulting to kangaroos, but the truth is that's what we have here. And as you pointed out, if it was impeachment, as in the previous two with Nixon and Clinton, those lawyers for the president would have been able to examine witnesses, present evidence, call their own witnesses, and they, the Dems in control, sure don't want that.
No. And what this resolution gives Adam Schiff and Jerry Nadler is veto power over the Republican caucus and the Republicans trying to level the playing field on behalf of the president. The White House is effectively being shut out of this entire process. And even though impeachment in the Constitution doesn't include the two words due process, I mean, come on. This is the entire basis of our society. So what is an impeachable offense? If we go back in time and we listen to the framers of the Constitution, in the Constitution it says a president should be impeached for abuses of power that subvert the Constitution, the integrity of government, or the rule of law. President has not subverted the Constitution, no way, shape, or form. He's not subverted the rule of law. As for the integrity of government, I kind of laugh when I hear that one. But because it's exactly the lack of integrity of government that's trying to wipe Donald Trump off the face of the earth.
Well, not just today, Graham, and not recently after the election, but before the inauguration, there was impeachment talk, and it has been nonstop ever since. We want to impeach Donald Trump for fill in the blank. For a long time, it was Russian collusion. Then it was, we're going to take everything that Bob Mueller finds in his special investigation, and those are all impeachable offenses. Yep. Then that tipped over and fell down a hole. Now it's the Ukraine. The truth is, the Congress, under the Constitution, has the right to impeach the president for whatever they define high crimes and misdemeanors to be. In this case, it's we hate that guy at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. We're going after him for something. We're not sure what yet, but we will get there before we vote. In the meantime, the polls are turning against the charade. Americans want people in Congress to govern them, to solve problems, not to try and overturn the 2016 election, which is what this is.
And Nancy Pelosi, I betcha, I know she's watching the polls. She's watching the polls in the all-important swing states in the 2020 presidential election. Wisconsin, Nevada, North, maybe South Carolina included in there. Michigan, she's watched Florida. She's watching those. And right now, overall, taken in the aggregate, those states I just mentioned there, they're all in the majority against impeaching the 45th president of the United States. Barry, thank you.